Welcome to this spoken tutorial on managing DSpace user accounts. In this tutorial, we will learn to manage ePersons and create a group of ePersons and manage them. This tutorial is recorded using Ubuntu Linux OS 18.04, DSpace version 6.3, and Firefox web browser. However, you may use any web browser of your choice. To practice this tutorial, you should have installed DSpace 6.3 on your system. Tomcat service should be running, administrator's authority in DSpace, a working internet connection. If not, then please go through the prerequisite tutorials on this website. This tutorial assumes that you have done the immediate previous tutorial assignment in this series. If not, please do so before proceeding ahead. DSpace administrator can manage all the ePerson users. DSpace administrator can add an ePerson, edit an ePerson's profile, and delete an ePerson. Let us learn how to manage ePerson users. Open a web browser and go to the DSpace interface. Log in to DSpace with the administrator account you created earlier. I will log in with my administrator account. We are now on the admin's My DSpace page. Click on the Logged In tab at the top right corner. Select Administer from the drop-down list. We are now in the Administer dashboard. In the top navigation bar, click on the Access Control tab. From the drop-down list, select ePeople. The Administer ePeople page opens. Now we will add an ePerson using admin authority. To do so, click on the Add ePerson button in the Administer ePeople section. Edit ePerson page opens with some fields where we can type in the ePerson's details. By default, DSpace generates an ID for every ePerson, and the same is displayed in the email field. First, remove the default ID in the email field. Then, type the email of a new ePerson to be created in DSpace. I will type last name and first name of the ePerson as shown here. By default, the value for language is set to English. Next, enable the Can Login checkbox by clicking on it. It controls the login authority of ePerson. If the checkbox is not selected, the ePerson cannot log in to DSpace. If the checkbox is selected, the ePerson can log in to DSpace. For this demonstration, I will leave the Require Certificate checkbox unchecked. This is the Reset Password button. This allows the ePerson to set or reset the password of his DSpace user account. Click on Reset Password button. By doing so, a new ePerson account will be created in DSpace based on our inputs. A mail containing a link to reset the password will be sent to the given mail ID. Let us log out from the administrator account. Now, we will log in to the mail account which we have specified in the email ID field earlier. Here is the change password request mail that we received from DSpace. Open the change password request email. Click on the given URL to change the password. Enter new password page opens. Type the new password. I will type the password as U5Pass. Retype the same password in the Again to Confirm field. Then click on the Set New Password button at the bottom of the page. Password changed message is displayed. We have successfully created a new ePerson user using administrator authority. Next, we will learn how to edit the profile of an ePerson as an admin. Open dSpace interface. Log in to dSpace with administrator authority and go to the administer page. In the top navigation bar, click on the tab Access Control. From the drop-down list, select ePeople. The Administer ePeople page opens. Click on the Select ePerson button at the bottom of the page. Select ePeople pop-up window opens up. It displays all the user's details like ID, email, last name, first name and language. To select a particular ePerson, click on the Select button adjacent to the ID column. I will select the user with email ID dspace.u5@gmail.com. Immediately, we will be redirected to the Administer ePeople page. Here, we can see the first name, last name and email ID of the selected ePerson in the text box. To edit the profile for that ePerson, click on the Edit button next to the text box. Let me click the Edit button. Edit ePerson page opens along with the ePerson's details. These fields are editable. For this demonstration, I will update first name as shown. Click the Save button to update the details. The ePerson user's profile is successfully updated. Likewise, we can also delete a user from dSpace. To do so, click on the Delete button in the Administer ePeople after selecting the user. For this demonstration, I am not deleting any user. Next, let us understand about groups in dSpace. Group in dSpace is a collection of ePersons. Administrator and Anonymous are two built-in groups in dSpace. Administrator group has full authority of dSpace. Anonymous group has only read permissions in dSpace. dSpace creates default groups for all the roles in the community and collection. And default read and write permissions are assigned to default groups. Additionally, an administrator can create custom groups. As per requirement, custom read and write permissions can be assigned to the custom groups. Now, let us proceed to create a custom group using admin authority. Switch to dSpace interface. In the top navigation bar, click on the Access Control tab. From the drop-down list, select Groups. Group Editor page opens. Here, we can see two groups, Administrator and Anonymous. To create a new group, click on the Create New Group button in the Group Editor section. Edit Group interface appears. By default, dSpace generates group ID and assigns it in the name field. Remove the default group name. Set the group name as Content Submitters. ePerson members and other existing groups can be added as a member to the new group. Let us add the ePerson as a group member. Click on the Select ePeople button below the ePerson Members field. The Select ePeople pop-up window opens up. Click on the Add button adjacent to the ID of the respective ePerson. Let us add a new user with the email ID dspace.u2@gmail.com. Also add another user with the email ID dspace.u5@gmail.com. If you wish to add more members, then repeat the same steps. Once done, close the Select ePeople pop-up window by clicking on the Close button. Immediately, the selected user will be added to the ePerson Members field. We can also remove a member from a group. To do so, first select the respective member to be removed from the ePerson Member field. Click on the Remove Selected button below the ePerson Member field. For this demonstration, I am not removing any user. Once done, click on the Update Group button at the bottom of the page to update the changes. Let us cross-verify all these changes. In the top navigation bar, click on the Access Control tab. From the drop-down list, select Groups. Group Editor page opens. Here, we can see our new group content submitters. We have now successfully created a new group and added members to it. Let us log out this user from the DSpace interface. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learned to manage ePersons and create a group of ePersons and manage them. As an assignment, create a content reviewers group. As a group member, add the two new ePersons that were created earlier in the series. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops and gives certificates. For more details, please write to us. Please post your timed queries in this forum. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by MHRD, Government of India. DSpace Spoken Tutorial Series is funded by the National Virtual Library of India, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. This script and the video for this tutorial was contributed by Pankaj Patil from IIT Bombay. And this is Nancy Verkey signing off. Thank you for joining.